farmers want to maximize their profits, or in other words, they want the best from their livestock. But in most cases, most of them do not know how to maximize their profits, or they do not know that you could actually apply technology to maximize profits. On this edition of Kilimo Bora, join me, Emily Mbai.
And Kalebo Dongo Koe, as you speak with Mr. Khobondo, who will be telling us about the application of biotechnology in enhancing livestock production.
So welcome, Mr. Khobondo.
Thank you so much.
So just get us an introduction. Tell us, what is this biotechnology monster that you're talking about?
Biotechnology, in general terms, means applications of biological knowledge to practical human need. It means knowing the biology, then you apply the biology to meet the need of people.
Or to solve a problem. So you can look at the society, you see that there is this problem, and then with your biological knowledge, you apply that and then you solve that problem.
Yes, exactly.
Wow. Now, if you could just give us maybe more importances apart from solving of problems.
So far, biotechnology has solved so many problems that we had before. For example, we know that, if you're interested in a cow only produces two animals, at any given time, or one. But through the use of biotechnology, you can have 10.
Wow.
It's possible.
So 10 cows.
10 cows from the same
parents. From the same parents.
Parents, yeah.
Yeah.
Another example is, let me give you an example of a bull. If you have a bull, let's say, in Canada, through the use of biotechnology, instead of importing the bull to Kenya, you can extract the semen and bring it here.
So that's where that's from the place we have the artificial insemination.
Artificial insemination.
So getting straight into the story, Mr. Khobondo, could you please explain to us how this technology has revolutionized animal science?
A lot has been done. A lot has been done. And I want to restrict myself to genetics and animal breeding because that's why my specialization is. If I give you an example, in animal breeding, we deal with selection and mating. Now, for you to select a cow, for example, that is high producing, you must leave the cow, you must keep the cow up to maturity. Then you get get the production of the milk. And you select based on the phenotype, that is in milk production.
Yeah.
In the use of biotechnology, you can select a cow from the womb. That's one revolutionary act.
How do you do that?
It's possible. It's possible. You do marker-assisted selection, and currently there's genomic selection. And there's a cow. Let's take a bull. You know that you can use semen. To inseminate. Not in the natural way, but in an artificial way. Let's say that the bull is in the USA. And you want the semen here. Would you carry the bull from the USA to Kenya?
You can't even go to the airport with that bull.
Yes.
Yeah.
So through the use of biotechnology, you can import the germplasm of that bull from the USA to Kenya.
Now that is very, very interesting. I mean, I think biotechnology is all about taking control.
Exactly.
I think you have control over everything. If you
anything
want milk production, you can get, you can maximize on milk production if you so wish. So that one has got me thinking, Mr. Khobondo. Does this biotechnology have a history maybe? Like, where did it start? How has it grown or something like that?
It started from time immemorial. Time immemorial. But people didn't know that it was biotechnology. But with time, it has changed. And it has changed the human nature into the extent that where we are going, we don't know.
Yeah.
For example, you know, we can have two of you.
Wow.
Using biotechnology. You only take your cell and we clone you from the cell. You know of the dolly sheep?
Yes, yes.
So that's one example. Currently, we have got what we call this the copy number variation. We are looking at how complexity of organism can be looked inside the genome and look at how specific regions within the genome are copied. That also defines the difference that we see in animals as well as human beings.
Okay, so does this have branches? We have talked about animals, we have talked about human beings, or are there branches in this biotechnology thing?
The branches of biotechnology are into two.
Mm-hmm.
We have got technologies that alter reproduction. Mm-hmm. And I think most of my examples have been based on that,
mm-hmm.
where we have artificial insemination, we have embryo transfer, we have cloning,
mm-hmm.
we have three-parent offspring. Then we have another branch, which is molecular genetics.
Mm-hmm.
In molecular genetics, you look at the animal or the living organism at the DNA level. For example, you can extract a gene and transfer it into another animal,
yeah.
or another species altogether, mm-hmm. what we call genetic engineering.
Wow. Now, you have mentioned something that has just caught me, a three-parent offspring. I mean, how is that even possible?
Yeah, it is possible, and it is used to solve genetic diseases. And these are genetic diseases that are found on the mitochondrial DNA.
Mm-hmm.
So we know that we have got two types of DNA.
Mm-hmm.
We have got the nucleus DNA and the mitochondrial DNA. Surprisingly, the mitochondrial DNA is found from the maternal aspect.
Mm-hmm.
So that means that the DNA that is transferred
mm-hmm.
comes from the line of the dam or the line of the mother.
Mm-hmm.
Now you can exclude that line,
mm.
but still have a viable offspring.
Mm.
So what do? You have got an animal,
mm-hmm.
or the parent of the genetic material that you are interested in. That is a dam,
mm.
and a male,
mm-hmm.
a female and a male. Then you have a donor.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So the donor will provide an egg, but without genetic material. So it will only provide the mitochondrial part of it. Then from the maternal donor,
mm-hmm.
that's the female,
mm-hmm.
that is of high genetic material, we extract the ova.
Mm-hmm.
Within the ova, there is the nucleus.
Mm-hmm.
That's where the genetic material is.
Mm-hmm.
Then you extract that nucleus and its content. And from the other side, you do away with the nucleus. Yeah. Then you come and fuse them. So you take or you inject the nucleus of interest into the ova that doesn't have nucleus.
Yeah.
Wow.
Then you fertilize them
then
in the lab.
Then you fertilize using the male.
Yeah, using the male.
Mm-hmm.
Then you transfer them into the donor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
In that way, you have a parent, an offspring that has got
three parents.
Yeah.
Wow.
So that's so interesting. Mr. Khobondo, this topic seems getting interesting bit by bit, Emily.
Yes.
And now we would like Mr. Khobondo to explain for us, from where you sit as a specialist in this field, what is the state of Africa?
We are moving, but we are lagging behind.
Mm.
However, through the donor fundings, we are really trying.
Mm.
You know, Becker is in Ilri.
Yeah.
So all these facilities to do this work is there.
Mm.
Here at Tijaton, we also have a department of biochemistry.
Yeah.
I hope they are doing their work.
Mm.
Here at INSEP, or equally, we also have a small lab that we are trying to bring in the modern facilities to do this work.
So we are heading there.
Oh, exactly.
We're on a very, very right track.
We are in the course.
And soon we'll be hitting the international stage.
Actually, we are in the course.
And then
maybe to expand on that is that, you see, this one also comes along with the personnel.
Yeah.
Yeah. So far, within the Department of Animal Science, we have got five geneticists.
Oh,
led
that's
by
amazing.
Professor Kai.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we are working in hand to bring change.
And then we have, before we wind up this conversation, we have the last question, Emily. How has biotechnology been used in livestock science?
A lot.
Mm.
I think I've given an example.
Yeah.
Mostly on the reproductive aspect.
Mm.
And maybe, sorry, I didn't explain the second branch of biotechnology,
yeah.
which is the molecular genetics.
Mm-hmm.
And to address that question, I'll deal with that.
Yeah.
Now, we know what we call a fingerprint.
Yeah.
A fingerprint is, at molecular level, how do I resemble my siblings? Or how do an animal resemble his siblings?
Mm.
So that is one way on which biotechnology can be used.
Yeah.
Then you also have what we call marker-assisted selection.
Yeah.
Where I use molecular marker to select an animal before its maturity, before its birth.
Mm.
Then we have got what we call genomic selection, where you sequence the whole genome. Then within that genome, there are regions that are different. And it's this region that confers variation. So you can pick those differences and use to select future parents of the animal. Then lastly is what we call the copy number variation, which people are really working on.
Yeah.
What I said is that within the genome, there are regions that are the same.
Yeah.
But they are not the same across all the animals, even if they come from the same species.
Mm.
Yeah, there's variation in the copy number. Yeah, that's how the name comes, copy number variation.
Copy number variation.
So you can also use that.
Mm.
You can apply quantitative genetics to depict that variation. Mm. And it's possible.
Now, Mr. Khobondo, you see, on this program, what we emphasize on is helping the farmer out there. So if I could just, before we let you go, for example, let's take, I am a farmer.
Yeah.
For example, let's say I'm somewhere in Nyandarua,
yeah,
and I have had this interesting conversation, and I want to apply this to maximize on my profits and output. What am I supposed to do, or who am I supposed to approach, or is it applicable only to companies and big organizations, or can a local farmer who can afford it do it?
Yeah, we have got farmers who are contacting us.
Mm-hmm.
Serious farmers. Who knows that farming is business?
Yes.
Yeah. For example, here in Egerton and at INSEP, we offer artificial insemination in chicken.
Mm-hmm.
So there are people who are no longer using cocks. So once they identify the cock, they call the expertise, they go, they teach them how to inseminate a chicken. That is very much applicable.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing is on semen. So instead of using your bull, you go to agent, Kai's agent, who are selling semen.
Mm-hmm.
These are semen of high genetic animals that if you are interested in dairy milk production, you'll have your milk production enhanced instead of using the bull. So all these are applicable. Where we haven't reached because of resources is things to do with the molecular selection, because they are very expensive.
Yeah.
Okay, now if you are a farmer out there, you know where to go, and obviously you know that biotechnology is the way to go. What do you say, Koyo?
I think this for the future of an African farmer, it's simply the way to go, whether sheep in or sheep out.
Yes, it is taking control. Basically, with this, I think you can control everything.
You want
more milk, you can get
you
more
can
milk.
Get it.
You want big hands, you can get them. Wow, that is pretty interesting. So it was a pleasure talking to you,
Thank
Mr. Khobondo.
Thank
you so much for coming through. And that was it, sadly, on this edition of Kilimo Bora. I have been your host, Emily Mbai.
And Kale Budongo Koyo.
Until next time, I will say God bless you.